We learnt four properties of metals in earlier video. Can we name for them for me? Metallic luster, malleability, ductility, and they are hard. These were the four properties, right? Can you think that some more properties of metals? Metal utensils are used for cooking. Are they? What do you think they are used for this purpose? Which energy we need to cook food? Heat energy. Correct. We need heat energy to cook food, and metal utensils are good conductors of heat. They help transfer of heat evenly through the entire surface and provide heating. No doubt, most of metals are to be good conducting of heat. Do you know the two best conductors of heat? They are silver and copper. Two other metals like lead and mercury are comparatively poor conductors of heat. Electric wires also made up of metals, right? Why is that? It's because they are good conductors of electricity too. If we have a battery bulb connected in a circuit with a metal wire, you will see that the bulb will glow when the switch is closed. And because they are conductors of electricity, they are coated with rubber-like material. This rubber-like material acts as an insulator, which protects us from being electrocuted. If we touch the wire by mistake, do you know any other properties of metals? What happens when we strike a hard surface, like utensils banging against the sink? Can you hear sound produced by metal? Yes, this another property of metals, we can call metals as sonorous, meaning they produce sound when hit against a hard surface. No doubt, school bells, church bells in the temple are made up of metals. If these are the characteristics of metals, what do you think the characteristics of non-metals? In simple words, just the opposite of metals. In your nature, non-metals like carbon, iodine, or sulfur do not have luster. They don't shine and brittle in nature. What do you mean by brittle? Cannot be beaten into sheets or wire. Most of them turn into powder hit by the hard substances. Non-metals can also be gases like oxygen, hydrogen, or solids, carbon, sulfur, etc. Do you know of any non-metals in the liquid state? Bromine is the only non-metal which is in the liquid state. Non-metals do not conduct heat or electricity, and they do not produce the sound hit against the hard surface. This means that they don't have the property sonority. So, isn't it easy or simple to differentiate between metals and non-metals? Only on the basis of their physical properties. Wait, mercury is a metal in a liquid state at room temperature, and bromine is a non-metal in a liquid state at room temperature. How do we differentiate between the two based on physical properties? We can say that all metals solids at room temperature, except mercury. and all non-metals, either solid or gaseous, except bromine. Well, this is not it. There are few more exceptions that break the physical appearance norms of metals and non-metals. For example, most metals have high melting point, which means that they need large amount of heat to melt. But look at the two metals, gallium and cesium. They melt when you keep them on palm. We must say these two metals have very low melting point. Look at another exception of non-metals. Iodine is, for example, non-metal. It has property of metals. Can you point out which property I am talking about? Correct, luster. Iodine has shine or luster, which is technically the property of metals. Take another example, carbon, for instance. What is carbon? Is it a metal or non-metal? Yes, carbon is a non-metal. But look at diamond, graphite. They come from carbon. They are known as allotropes. Different forms in which carbon exists are called its allotropes. Let us look at the allotropes of carbon. It is known as the hardest substance, as an extremely high melting point and boiling point. All these properties of metals, but it is surprisingly diamond is an allotrope of carbon, which is a non-metal. Diamond too is a non-metal, which strongly exhibits the property of metals. Now that we know of so many exceptions, do you think it is easy to differentiate between metals and non-metals based on their physical properties? I doubt that, but don't worry. There is another way out of this. It is to differentiate two based on their chemical properties. How is the term? For that you have to watch next video. Thank you. Thanks for watching the video.